the 88, when after 88 uprising, many of the democracy pro-democracy groups, when after the there was a crushing down of the democracy movement by violent means, by killing and shooting, you know, many of the opposition and the students of RUN came to the border, and then they came to the Karen areas along the border here, and when they usually went for meetings and all, they have to use the headquarters, no? The Karen general headquarters, Maniplau, as their basis. No? So the students also, the ABSDF, no? Students also have the office then, also in Maniplau. And also when the NDF or DAB was formed, they used Maniplau as the headquarters, no? DAB is a Democratic Alliance of Burma, DAB. NDF, the National and National Democratic Front. So when these organized, they have their headquarters in Maniplau. So this has become very, very important for all the opposition groups, not only for the Karen, also for the NLD, for the students and all. And my father-in-law also died after a few months, after the fall of Maniplau. There's always fighting along the border here. And the soldiers try very hard to, especially the military, to attack the headquarters. But Maniplau is in a very strategic location. It is impossible for the military, for the Burmese. They cannot bomb it. They cannot use the plane to attack it. So there's no way for them because it's well guarded. But what happened is when this handful of the small group of the Buddhist group, when they have been to being what you call, this is part of the military strategy. They use this religion as a part of their strategy to split the Karen. So saying that these Buddhist soldiers, because you are Buddhist, you will never be promoted to the higher position. You will not be given a high rank. You cannot be the officers because you are Buddhist, because all the leaders are all Christians, like that. So this came up, and then few of the soldiers, they joined this movement, and this started with very small rumors or something like that, but it became stronger and stronger, and now with the military knowing that this is their plan or the strategies, it works. So they encouraged these people with the DKBA. Started with this monk, Mianjingu, they call this Mianjingu Xiao. It's the monk, he's the leader of that group. But people know he's backed by the military, by the military and all the people. When this group splitted, because part of the security for the headquarters, Maniplau, it is under their control. So when they join with the military, with the Burmese soldiers, it means they keep it open for attack. So they're part of the security where they have they are responsible for the security. It's open for attack. So finally, the Burmese military with the DKBA, they captured Maniplau. The Karen leaders, they want to defend it. But they know if they defend it, it will only cost many deaths. Many people die because of that. And also it will only mean the Karen people killing Karen again. So they thought it is not worth risking many lives. So they just left Maniplau. The DKP is split from the Karen army and they joined the Burmese. And they are being backed up by the Burmese, the soldiers. And then they capture the headquarters. This group, they are not joining the ceasefire movement. They are fighting, but because the military says, if you you join us, you work with us, it means that if you have this the DKBA, the Democratic Karen Buddhist Army, and you fight, and we will support you, and so. Many of these soldiers, the DKBA, Even the leaders, many of them, or most of them, are illiterate. No? Even one of the leaders, General Panui from the 7th Brigade here. Panui, he can't speak even Burmese. No? He can't even read and write. But he was given the general, General Panui, like that. But they don't have any education, huh? Most of them lack of education and lack of this one. So when you are illiterate or when you are ignorant, it's very easy. You can be easily manipulated, huh? You can be controlled and all like that. So until now, there's a problem with that one, and that is the reason why the Maniplau fell also. When Maniplau was there as the headquarters of the clan, it meant that you can stay as the people are struggling for your independence and your rights, and having your army, having your own headquarters, then it is very difficult. You can even have your regular meetings and offices, everything going on well with your headquarters totally under your control. But when after the fall of Maniplau, it means that you have the fall of your headquarters. It means that you have split it. You have to go and stay here and there, and all the leaders are scattered like that. It's very difficult to get together when you don't have any headquarters anymore. In fact, we have many places along the border where stay under the clan army, the clan control. But it is very difficult to go from one place to another place because it is traveling is very difficult. And aside from that, there are so many military operations, so many Burmese soldiers. Now, the other side, in the Burmese side, in the clan own land, you see there are, we have the Burmese here, the clan here, the DKBA here, or like that. No? Yeah. They are all together moving here and there, and aside from that, there are so many landmines. Eh?